Y'all know what it is.
Aww.
Buffalo is in the building. $1 million worth of game is going down. Yeah, this is a serious edition right here. You know what it is.
I'm in Salvatore, making salat.
Yeah.
Been taking three flavors. Shoot the nigga now, we speak later. Up to Whitney, got the Mac with me, hit behind the Warhol. Dip the Bergdorf, shut up the whole store. Cherry 57 in the back, learn the lessons.
Crack
it,
lesson.
Drying it, be ready in a second.
In
40 chains on, halo, I'm a guard, nigga.
Fear
a guard, jog a rocket, nigga. I don't even jog, hanging out the wax, the sunroof. Pick a nigga off. With the chill bezel, all my phones ready, make me feel special. Banana pill, AK, I'm looking real extra. With the top keys and money green Teslas.
Money green Tesla.
Right brick on my brick. Right brick on my brick. Tone Virgil, right brick on my brick. Ayo. A Mary's filled with cash, I'm in the fashion district.
Fashion district.
Shoot your mama house before a half of picking. All my niggas dealing, all my niggas killing. The niggas try to test me, now the niggas missing. Milk quarters, I'm still awesome. Water whip coke, I still force it. Rosé out the faucet. Tell Virgil right brick on my brain.
Lil' bro,
come on,
guys. He's 30, he ain't even flinch. Caught the body, dipped to the A, nobody seen him since.
Nobody seen him.
Five seen things, and I ain't need the tents. My weakest scent cost more than your mama needs for rent.
That's just for one cent. Right,
the drum rip, leave you rinse. Hide the body for a week and it's gonna leave a stench. Rappers coming to my city, they gon' need consent. Cause we already
know you ask somebody,
nigga, we convinced. I told Virgil, right brick on my brick.
On my
the
brick.
Nicest with this shit, ain't right this, I just spit. White bitch on my dick, this ice drip on my fist. No shoe deal, but look at all this Nike shit that I get. On Doe Street, this white shit that I pitch. 2 in the morning on the corner, night shift
like
with my
chill.
Dick. No soda in this off-white shit that I whip. I'm rich, put all this off-white shit on my bitch.
My bitch.
So if it's smoke, we ain't even asking.
I'm letting it go.
Just pulling
I gotta
up
let it
somebody
go.
Gonna see a cash
go.
Nash and Benny like James Worthy.
Y'all gotta get this.
Magic. Every time Griselda drop, the shit gonna be a classic.
Come on,
Benny. And OK's the shooters, all cocky. Vintage Versace with the stone face Medusa.
That's how I used to rap.
And Maggiano,
but I can
we
rap.
Got gold plated Rugers, this pistol.
You're lying, nigga.
Nah, he just spit like that.
Got our lives on us, can we chill? Eating with snakes, probably getting killed. Cause trust me, A family had a Henry Hill.
And every listen, man, it's don't going got a down, man. Skill. It is going down, man. Listen, we got Buffalo in the building. I don't know if y'all understand what's going on. We got Buffalo in the building.
Yes.
Boom, boom, boom.
Boom, 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 boom. It's going down. Buffalo, man, is in the building, man. Griselda gang, they in here. Listen, man, there's some serious shit going on, man.
Real talk,
Buffalo, New York. Buffalo.
Huh?
That's what we'll be talking about today.
Got my motherfucking nigga. You know what I mean? I got my motherfucking nigga Shaq in the building. My motherfucking nigga Alvin in the building. My motherfucking nigga Desert Eagle in the motherfucking building.
Yeah, we know. If you know, you know. If you know, you know.
This nigga just talk to me.
If you know, you know. Shaq. We got Shaq. We know niggas by Shaq.
You know what I mean?
Definitely Shaq and Alvin. And
yes.
Because we know niggas that know niggas that know niggas. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. You know what I mean?
That's wild.
That's what's going down, man. Y'all fucking the game up right now. We going to get straight to that.
Thank you, man. Thank you for
y'all,
having
y'all
us.
Educating people. No, thank y'all for coming. Y'all educate people that it ain't no age limit on this shit. You know? What didn't stop y'all? A lot of motherfuckers fall back when, oh, I'm a certain age. I can't let this shit. I can't go. I ain't, you know what I mean? And I see that y'all ain't just jumping to, oh, you got to make a party song, make a song for the bitches. Make it. Y'all just stuck to y'all shit. Why did, what kept y'all so disciplined?
Being authentic, being us, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. I can't be nobody else besides Westside Gunn, you know what I'm saying? So at the end of the day, you know, it's like, I was in an A, you know what I'm saying, living out down there and all of that, you know what I'm saying, partying with the best of them, but, you know, when I used to rhyme, you know what I'm saying, it sounded like this then,
mm-hmm.
you know what I'm saying, 03, 04, all of that, so it was just like, when it was my time to shine, I just, you know, brought that to the table, you know what I'm saying, because that's the only thing I know, you know what I'm saying, I can if I want to rap on some trap shit, but it was just like, just being me coming out the gate, You know what I'm saying? And at that time, everybody from New York was trying to rap like they was from the South, you know, 2012. You know what I'm saying? Everybody. So I was just like, yo, I got to do something different. It's supply and demand. Like, I got to bring niggas into my world. You know what I'm saying? And that's what it was. I just stuck to the script. This shit still sound like that now. You know what I'm saying? I ain't changed up yet. I ain't made a party song yet.
And but you get in the bag. You get in the bag.
It's a matter of, you know what I'm saying, knowing that it wasn't, you know what I'm saying, when we getting up in age and doing this shit, it was a matter of, it wasn't about, you know what I'm saying, sitting down.
Pull that mic closer to you. Get it right.
It wasn't about sitting down with the labels or doing none of the shit that we doing now. It was about putting the dope shit out and getting the money off of it. You know what I'm saying? Like, you don't got to be, like, signed to a label. You don't got to be this. You know what I'm saying? That just so happens. That's how it happened. But, you know, niggas was basically based the hustle on themselves. You know what I'm saying? It wasn't relying on nothing else.
Believe that. Before we go any further, can you do me a favor? Can you just put that water right there on the... Yeah. Mm-hmm. Because this episode of Million Dollars Worth of Games is brought to you by New Hampshire Damn Vodka.
New Hampshire Damn.
Let me tell you something about New Hampshire Damn Vodka.
Tell them right here.
For real.
It's distilled 5 times. It's filtered 3 times for that clean, crisp finish. It's fucking absolutely wonderful for pre-gaming.
Yes.
And in about another week or so, or... couple days or so, is gonna be football season.
Football.
No, matter of fact, it's football season now.
Yes.
So when you're out and about at your local liquor store, you know, make sure you pick up some New Hampshire Damn Vodka, the official vodka.
Official.
Right here. Of Barstool Sports and the presenting sponsor.
$1 million worth of game.
Of $1 million worth of game. You feel what I'm saying? And also, shout out to the New Hampshire Damn Queen. We at the crib making the cocktails with the girls, and you know, they be over there having a great time. Partying and living it up, you know, fucking my house up off the New Amsterdam vodka. You know what I'm saying? So shout out to New Amsterdam. Make sure you get some.
I don't even drink, but let me get this. I want to taste it.
Where's his cup? He ain't got no cup.
I don't even drink. Unless I got to go out of respect. I got to taste it.
Look, he can have his whole bottle.
Yeah, No. We just going to give him a bottle to take with
him. He
want
to crack it. He want to crack it right now. 40 this shit.
Yeah.
He don't even know me. No, we can't be doing no 40.
No.
But we got him. We going to make sure we give him a whole bottle. We going to give him a whole bottle. You got the cases upstairs.
Let me ask y'all this question. Let's get right to the good shit. For years, New York City. I'm talking about New York. New York.
Big city of dreams.
Never claimed Buffalo. The fucking Bills, Jim Kelly, Thurman Thomas, Bruce fucking Smith, what was Andre fucking Reed.
Reed was a legend.
They never claimed none of them niggas. Never. But they claiming y'all.
New York City.
New York City. Nori sat right here on the couch. I said, tell me some niggas in New York that's popping. He said, Griselda gang. I said, nigga, they from Buffalo.
You remember you said that shit, Nori, right here.
You said that shit, nigga. You remember that Nori? Shit. I said, nigga, they from Nori, Buffalo, man. Nigga. Yeah. He said, no, they from New York, too.
He told me he made a trade. No,
How does it feel to be from Buffalo and finally get that fucking respect that y'all deserve?
Yes,
putting on the music side from the Mecca. Because New York City is the Mecca of the hip-hop shit.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
How it feel that it's like, yeah, nigga, yeah.
We them niggas.
Recognize, we them niggas too.
I feel great, you know what I'm saying? But like I said, go back to us just doing us. You know what I'm saying? And we earned that respect because... Mm-hmm. 2-3 years ago, they were still acting like that then too. You know what I'm saying? It really just been picking up like the last couple years, but they were still acting funny a few years ago. Yeah. You know,
shit changed quick.
You already know. We had to change that though. You know what I'm saying? But that just go about, you know, our hustle. You know what I mean? And just how dope we really are. You know what I mean? You gotta respect it. Like, even if you don't like us, you gotta respect it. You know what I'm saying? And like, you check the resumes, you know what I'm saying? It's not like we could check a lot of other resumes. I guarantee them shits don't check. You know what I'm saying? So it's just like, you know, at the end of the day, you know, we official dudes and, you know, we put in that work, man. And we hustle hard. So it's like, you got to respect it. Like, at the end of the day, you know what I mean? Like, now, the same dudes that was making a living trying to switch they shit to the South shit, they can't make a bag off that no more. Now they trying to come back and fuck with our wave. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
For real.
Like, everything that y'all do that I like is like, it connect with yesterday, the vinyl, all that stuff, the merch. Like, you know, when you think about merch, and I pump this to the young cast, merch is important to me. I just believe so. But when you think about merch, I'm thinking about like a rock band going on tour. Like, I'm not, you know, I don't remember too much rapper merch. You don't think about it. But the way y'all go with it, y'all just go fucking extreme on another level, because you understand, like, people want to wear your stuff because they feel you. And, you know, when you see, you know, we've seen Guns N' Roses, Metallica shirts growing up, Skid Row. You know, we always seen people wearing them, you know, at the gas stations, what we never knew. But y'all shit is like serious, the merch, and just the whole mindset of, you know, a motherfucker think you selling vinyl. What is it? They don't understand the market in vinyl. And how it's like y'all always say, this is art. Why you always say this is art?
Because it is. You know what I'm saying? Like, I feel like every project I make, I turn into Da Vinci. You know what I'm saying? It's like I try to paint a picture. And then, like, you know, with the merch, you know, it's not merch to me. I don't treat it like merch. I treat it like a real clothing brand. So, you know, Griselda Records come from Griselda by Fashion Rebel. So it was a clothing brand first anyway. You see what I'm saying? So, like, a lot of dudes, you know, they come out with music and then it's like, okay, let's focus on this merch. Like, I look at the merch. You know what I'm saying? You want to call it merch, but I look at designing before I even look at the music. So it's kind of like I approach it totally different. I approach the clothing part of it first. You know what I'm saying? So even when I design, I'm not even thinking like, you know, even for the project, because the project gonna do what it do, but it's like, damn, how can I turn this into people wanting to get this on vinyl, this cover? People want to wear this shirt. People want to, you know what I'm saying? So it's just like, I learned just a long time ago, like, the music money is straight, but it's what everything else you do is the bag. You know what I'm saying? So if you just focusing on music, you out here about to have a cup in your hands if you ain't switching up, doing something else. You know what I'm saying? Like, you gotta have more than one hustle. You know what I mean? And we've been doing another thing too. We've been wearing our own shit since we was 13, 14 years old. That's what I'm saying. And we not no spring chickens. So just imagine how many years we really been doing this.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? So it's just like a lot of dudes, like I said, they get a popular song, they get lit, they go on the road, then they make a shirt. That's not them. I was calling getting screen printed shirts, and we was getting custom shit when I was 12 years old.
That just come with not being no overnight success either. Like, we get seasoned. You know what I'm saying? You get seasoned. You get to learn and grind and come about it from a different angle. You know what I'm saying? Now we have different strategies, and, you know, we can connect with people, especially this generation that is so entrepreneurial. Like, you're able to connect with those people that are art connoisseurs and people that actually are making money from just, you know, even being, you know, a 9-to-5 or even being in the streets. We connect into a lot of different people. It's a movement. It's about more than just music. It's about, you know, owning your own shit, you know, being our own boss, you know, not signing to no major at first, you know what I'm saying? And being able to create your own wave and be able to, you know, actually, I guess, just, you know, get it out the mud. I think that's why so many people, like, respect it and connect to Griselda as a whole. It's like, because they're able to see themselves in us. They're able to see, like, you know, yeah, I didn't get on at this certain time, but I'm going to keep going. I'm going to keep grinding. Yeah. I'm going to keep, you know, doing it, because if they could do it, then I could do it.
I was talking to you, Benny, about y'all audience. Describe y'all audience, man, because y'all got a real, rather unique audience. I came to the Sony Hall thing. Westside had to join the Sony Hall. Con was there. You wasn't there, I don't think.
That's when I threw the money back in the car.
You threw the money back in the car when you had the red Montclair on. It was a crazy night. I'm talking about.
But they paid me for the show. I threw the money.
He threw
back.
The money back. He
back
threw the money
crowd,
back.
Merry Christmas.
It was crazy. I got that somewhere on my phone. But what was crazy about it was, like, I'm looking at the audience, but the people that was coming through, Q-Tip came through, a bunch of different people came through that night. Y'all audience, describe y'all audience and why it's so different than anybody else's.
Man, I want to describe it, because, like, I always tell this story. It's like, you know, these niggas is my family, but when they got wind under their wings with this rap shit, You know what I'm saying? I was somewhere else doing me. So I got to see it how everybody else saw it, but early. You know what I'm saying? We was kicking it earlier upstairs about how, like, you asked him when he first got, you know what I mean? And me, I had to realize it like everybody else. These niggas coming around with rollies on and doing shit. I'm like, fuck these niggas doing. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
You know what I mean? Real shit. And I paid close attention. I remember going to the show in Boston in 2016. I drove from Buffalo about 8 hours to Boston. These niggas had a show, told me pull up. I'm still living in the projects this early. And I seen it. It was Boston. It was like hardcore hip hop people. People who believe in this shit. It was grown people who could afford to buy $100 items. It was people who opinion mattered because they golden era fans. You know what I'm saying? So when I really think the fans like helped catapult Griselda to a certain point because, you know, it's what the game been missing. You know, a lot of people say that, but it's literally what the game been missing. So it's real hardcore fans. And I learned from the fans. I'm like, damn, everybody be chasing the kids, but a kid can't afford. You know what I'm saying? Like, the certain, you know, kids ask their parents for money. Our fans are the parents, you know what I'm saying, who could come, who could travel and get in hotel rooms and get in flights to a Griselda show and stand in the line for the meet and greet and buy merch. Like I said, and most importantly, their opinions matter because they're golden age hip-hop fans. So when they say, no, Griselda is this, we know, we listen, we come from that.
You know, they're qualified. Exactly. They're qualified to give y'all that title. Exactly. They could put that stamp on y'all. They got the certificate of proof because it's like, no, we grew up knowing this type shit. Because like I tell people, when I went to that show, it was like, hold up. I'm seeing all type of people up in this joint.
Yeah, that, like,
it was crazy.
Yeah, because that's the thing. Like, so you're gonna have your OG niggas that did 10.
Yeah.
Come home and be okay. Like, yo, this the illest shit I heard since the 90s.
Right.
You gonna have your niggas that's selling dope. Like, yo, you hear what these niggas talk about? They bagging up or they riding around, you know what I'm saying? Doing what they doing to it. Then you got your fly niggas. Like, yo, you heard the shit them niggas said. I ain't even know niggas was on that. Or that's the type of shit we on. We spending $1,000 for a t-shirt. We know exactly what he talking about. Then, you know what I'm saying? You got, because like my son, you know what I'm saying? Fly Guy Jr., he 19, he just turned 19. And I'm his friend's favorite rapper, you know what I'm saying? Because at the same time too, guess what? We wearing the shit they wearing, you know what I'm saying? So it's just like, it's bridging a gap, you know what I'm saying? That's really what it is. And it's wild because even like, you know, I have a store, so it's just like, it be kids coming in there, you know, 12, 13 years old with their grandmother or sitting in line, you know what I mean? I do a drop. They in line with their grandmother, 11 years old, 12 years old, wanting to support, you know what I'm saying? So it's just like, it's a wide range. And you got, like I said, you got your true hip-hop, you know, they figure like, feel like they, you know, the purists, you know what I'm saying? So they love the DJ Premier, the Alchemist, the Pete Rock, you know what I'm saying? But then you got songs, like I said, you got songs like, with everybody, you know what I'm saying? The 5 to 50s with the bounce. It's like real talk between every member of Griselda. We're going to give you every sound possible of hip hop. You know what I'm saying? It's like, it's not one sound that we can't do. So, and I don't think nobody, that's what I'm saying. We just too versatile, you know what I'm saying? And then it's just like, we on your head top, man. It's too many. Like, if I'm not dropping, she dropping. She ain't dropping, he dropping. He ain't dropping, he dropping. You know what I'm saying? So it's just like, we on your neck. You know what I'm saying? We on your neck.
And let me get a youth some game, right? About something Benny said that I don't want to go over y'all head. He said that they was already on, am I right?
They was doing anything.
They had a paid out show. They had shows that was already sold out. People coming there, people buying merch, people. He said, man, I was living in the projects in 2016. That was 5 years ago.
5 years ago, real shit.
5 years ago, this man sitting right here who doing tours, who performing in Made in America, who doing real shit out here, getting a real fucking bag.
A real one.
Was living in the projects 5 years ago. But real I want to commend and I want to give the flowers to Conway and Westside because y'all wasn't even all way established yet. But y'all took the shine that y'all had and y'all wasn't scared to shine it on another motherfucker. And for me, life is all about, see, to me, life ain't about you making it. Because a lot of motherfuckers get a chance to make it out. But your legacy is based on who the fuck did you help after you made it. Who you responsible for?
Who you put on?
Who you put on? Who can win a Grammy and say, and when they crying, they mention you? Who could, you know what I'm saying? Who, when you die, is going to hit that motherfucking stage at your motherfucking funeral and say, that nigga changed my life?
Yeah.
If it wasn't for that nigga, I'd probably be in jail. I'd be dead. Instead, I got millions of dollars and I changed my whole family fucking structure. Real shit. See, that's what real shit is about to me. It's not about when you make it out. It's about what you do after you make it out.
It's a fact.
So for me, for y'all niggas to reach down and see a young nigga from the projects, whether he was your cousin, whether he was a homie, whether he was a nigga you didn't know, you just knew he had talent, and say, no, come on, nigga. Come on this ride with us. That's some real shit, man. Because it ain't too many niggas out here that's willing to share that shine and not be worrying about a nigga taking they shine.
That's what I said. West came and got me out the hood. I was down bad, still owe my plug for another half. Every time you bring my name up, he get mad.
Nigga, fuck you, man. You ain't hold on. You ain't settled that debt yet. Yeah.
The fuck's going on?
Nigga want free tickets at every show and shit.
Listen, man.
Cause I know you was locked up in the state and the feds, right? Mm-hmm. So it's safe to say he's not good at playing hide and seek.
No.
They got locked up by both of them.
Both of them.
I took him on a run about 90 days.
Took him on a run.
He said 90 days.
90 days. It was the longest 90 days.
I was exhausted.
He was exhausted.
This episode of $1 Million Worth of Game is also brought to you by Manscaped. Mm. One thing about Manscaped, they take care of you at the places that, listen, I'm telling you, the most important place, the sack. Them jewels. You got to protect it. I'm talking about you got to protect their everything.
The nuts.
If you don't protect them, you're going to be in trouble. And like I used to be in the shower. Fuck! Ah!
Because
I'm cutting my sack. I was cutting my sack. That lawnmower changed my life. I'm talking about it really changed my life. And then on top of that, they also got, listen, I'm talking about the weed whacker for your nose.
Trim it right down.
I'm talking about the trim everything because you got dudes like him that walk around with afros hanging out of their nose. And I'm talking about dread, like all this stuff coming out of their nose.
I attack it, though.
Yeah, you attack it and all that. So that's definitely good. But one thing about Manscaped, they're going to hook you up. When you use the code MILLION, guess what? You're getting 20% off and you're getting free shipping. Mm. So what are you waiting for? Mm. What are you waiting for? What? Stop playing games. What you need to do is you need to go to manscaped.com, use the code MILLION, 20% off, free shipping. You get to clean the jewel area. You get to clean your nose. Mm. They got, you know, all type of cream, everything to go with it afterwards to make sure everything right. Mm-hmm. Manscaped.com, code MILLION. What are you waiting for?
Was you locked up with Sly Green? You was locked up with Sly Green? And you ain't knew about the biggest, you know what I mean?
I just talked to Sly last week.
That's what's up. How you doing?
No, he doing real good spirits. He love what we doing. You know what I'm saying? Like, he love what we doing. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's giving him, like, because you got to think, nobody never made it out of Buffalo. Mm-hmm. So for somebody to finally make it from Buffalo, I can just imagine how much shit he talking. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
For real. I just know
he up there in the yard giving them niggas head.
Nah, for real. For real, man.
If you see my niggas, fuck is y'all talking?
For real.
And for the people that don't know who he is, tell the people who he is to Buffalo.
I mean, you know, legendary. You know what I'm saying? Cover of Don Diva. You know what I'm saying? Four lights plus 130 years. Mm. Put you in the trunk. He only 5'5", 5'6", tops. You know what I'm saying? Putting 6'3" niggas in the trunk.
Man, this dude was scary.
Nah, for real. Like,
so he really an urban legend.
People was scared to even come out the house when he was on his bullshit. You know what I'm saying? Like, it was you know, we was younger, but you know, you knew everything was going on because his name was just ringing bells like that. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, but he, it's wild. Like, he really a good dude though. You know what I'm saying? Mm. Like real shit, real good dude, solid. One of the smartest people I ever met in my life. You know what I'm saying? And you know, he wake up every day. His focus is on getting niggas home.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Law library law every library. Day. I know what I'm saying. He got his own law firm. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah. Like, you know he in the jail.
Nah, he getting niggas' times back. Like, Sly doing real good. You know what I mean?
Shout out to Sly, because Sly and Low had, so Low was a bootleg prison lawyer too, but he was getting niggas, he was getting niggas more time.
That wasn't one of my
he
jobs.
He was like, I had 60. Now I got 160.
No, that wasn't my, I wasn't that sharp. Man. You got to be sharp. He's really sharp. Who he talking about?
Now hold on, one of y'all was in the county jail. One of y'all did tick in the county. Who was that?
I did a little county time.
Okay, somebody was upstate. That was you.
I was in the feds.
Right
oh,
here.
You was in the feds.
I went upstate. Yep.
Stayed in the feds, man.
Now, did y'all have any jobs in prison? Because Wallow had multiple jobs
hell
in prison.
Yeah.
He was a motherfucking lifeguard in the prison shower.
You lying.
He was, he was a chef. He was the prison chef.
Y'all niggas worked in the kitchen.
That's a fact. You know, that's the first job
you got to steal the onions and the peppers for your whip up. See, I'm telling you the game, man. It's the game. Mm-hmm. You got to stay righteous.
I used to be in the kitchen serving. I used to have a bag under the joint.
Dropping it right in your bag.
I ain't going front. I was an orderly, man. I was just chilling. I ain't want to do shit, man. It was
you got motherfuckers that don't be want to do shit.
The COs were smooth. And then Thrasher, man, he short when he wants to. So it was just like, man, we was in the cell. We was in the day room. We really didn't do too much. You know what I'm saying?
You
so
can
I
tell when they got a little
the
money on his books. I ain't doing shit.
Niggas, they got their money on their books. They ain't doing shit.
He like, you know, my shit was filled up.
He got his cabinet, his pantry. He got all his mackerel, his tuna.
But for real, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, just even in Philly, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I mean? I got to build with Nicky Scar for a lot of times.
Yeah, Nicky from.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I got to build with TL from Junior Black Mafia. You know what I mean? Anthony Long a lot of times. Like, that's you know what I mean? That's that was
Buffalo
up,
hub
you know
is like
saying?
The Philly hub.
Philly, same, y'all was in the same, all right, the same people was there in that region. Now, Con, you know, I'm going to say this. It was like, I don't know, I think it was during the quarantine, a little at the end. I get a phone call from Conway. Yo, what's up, Lo? I need you. I said, what the fuck you need me to write some shit? Because I was ghostwriting for Jadakiss and the Gil and a couple other niggas when I was in jail. I saw some raps to Fan Club and Jada because they wound up in their shit. I told Kiss know what time, and that's another story. So I'm like, damn, he need me to ghost for him. He need me to write some shit for him. He said, man.
I need you to wash my car.
Get the fuck out of here.
I heard you as a hell of I heard you clean the shit out of cell. I can imagine what you did to a car.
I did think about cleaning cars, but that's another story when I was younger. So Khan say, man, I need something. I said, what? Fuck you. He said, man, I need you to do this intro for me. I sent that. I don't know how long it took. I might have took 5 minutes. Right. Sent it back. It was a masterpiece. So, you know.
Wait, hold on. Man, you just can't say the shit was a masterpiece.
That's what he told me.
Was it a masterpiece? Like,
yeah, nah, it was fire.
That's what he told me.
He said it was fire.
So when we went.
Fire to masterpiece is two different choices.
This shit going
to
win a Grammy. Right. You know what I mean? But that's another story.
It definitely. It better be.
This shit is, this is legendary.
It's got to be at least nominated for sure.
For something.
Like, album is incredible.
Like when you was making that shit, right? When this, what made you say to yourself, like, I'm gonna call, what made you call me?
You popped up on this fucking feed. Get up. What you doing? Stop. Listen.
I ain't gonna lie. Like, that, you know, that's partly true. Like, you know what I'm saying? I be tapped into them shits on the gram and on the internet and shit. Like, you know, I be soaking up that game. You know what I'm saying? And I just be. You know, I just had this vision, like, yo, I want to have bro on there just talking this shit in his bag. I think that'll be hired on the album. And shit, that's when I'm like, let me hit this nigga. You know what I'm saying? And, but I ended up putting that shit on the end of this song though. That's on the album though, instead of the intro.
Yeah, it's cool. It was cool.
Yeah, but it's on the actual record.
Song number 8.
Shit, dumb.
Yeah. I mean, but
you trying to plug yourself just now?
No, I wasn't.
He was trying to make himself seem cool. What made you call me?
No, that's what I got. That's when I got inducted into the
We gonna give you flowers.
I'm just saying, I'm the fifth member.
The fuck out of here.
So you know what I mean?
It was you.
Who?
Huh?
What you mean?
What's your name? Look, he don't even know his name. No.
I'm the fifth member. Today he said I could put it out there.
How you the fifth member? You don't even know the fucking name.
My name Wallo the Banker.
Oh my goodness.
I get that money. He's the butcher. I'm the bank. He deal with the food. I deal with the money.
Get the fuck out of here.
It don't fucking matter. But like, Con, like, you know, you've been through stuff. You know what I mean? When you was laying on that table, because we all had that moment in life sometime where we think, what was going through your mind? Did you think you wasn't going to make it?
Nah, I knew I was, I was out, like, so I woke up, I was good, like, I didn't even really realize what happened, kind of. I just was, like, tubed up, and just, you know what I mean, fucked up and shit, but I could think about when I didn't think I would be able to, like, walk again and stuff, and when I first seen, like, that my face was paralyzed, like, you know what I'm saying, I know, I definitely was thinking, like, it's over. You know what I'm saying? Honestly, let me keep it a buck. Like, I ain't even want to live no more, Wallo.
Damn, what motivates you to live?
My kids, you feel me? My son, at the time, I ain't had my second son, my baby yet, but my son. You know what I'm saying? And then just, like, I don't know, for some reason in the hospital, I just was like, I'm going to still be iller than niggas anyway. You know what I'm saying? Like, but once I thought this rap shit was over for me, it was just like, because I sacrificed so much and I put so much into this, into making this shit, making this dream come to fruition, that, you know what I mean? Once the doctor saying I ain't going to walk and all that, you know, that shit, like, I'm just like, I wish niggas would have smoked me. You know what I'm saying?
Damn. But now, you say you thought the rap shit was going to work. You remember, I think it was time you talked about, you know, laying on the homie couch and shit. And you was trying to, you know, the homie, I forgot, you told me his name. It was one of the homies that used to stay at his crib. Mm-hmm. What was his name?
Dread.
Yeah. And you was just like, it was rough. And you talked about it, and I think Care For Me, what was the song? Care For Me. You remember the song? You was talking about it, the baby counted you out.
Proud of me.
So it was Proud of Me. You went the fuck in that song. And it was personal. And it was like, motherfucker shitted on me. Like, damn, you.
Right.
You looked at me like I was a, because you know how many people that's older and people look at him like, nigga, you know how baby, nigga, you try and rap, especially the baby moms. Baby moms in the ghetto with some, they will cut you deep. Oh, nigga, you out here. Oh, you a rapper now, huh? Fuck my son need, they will kill you when you, cause you know that hurt and all the shit, the let down and all that, you know what I mean? Yeah. So they looking at you.
And it's a stigma.
It's a stigma. And it's fuck you up. They can fuck you up.
If you don't blow or you don't make it in rapping by a certain age, it's over for you.
Right.
It's a stigma. Right. So even your baby mom or your girlfriend or somebody fall into that stigma of trying to talk you out of chasing your fucking dreams.
They'll kill
you.
I'm
saying, you
especially where we from, you know what I'm saying? Because
nobody ever made it.
Where it's never been done before.
So they're like, y'all niggas tripping. Y'all niggas fucking tripping.
Every day in our life,
y'all is practicing. History.
You know what I'm saying? So it's like, it's never been done before. It's like, so you about to pull a rabbit out of a hat right in front of me. You know what I'm saying? Shit never been done before.
You know, like, nigga, you tripping.
But y'all had to believe. Let me ask you a question, Kyle. When it happened to you, and the doctors told you that, and you felt how you felt, and you went through all them emotions, and then you realized that, nope, doc, you was wrong. You said I might not walk again, but God said I'm going to walk again, and I'm going to talk again. Mm-hmm. How much did that fuel your fire to be like, y'all niggas gave me another chance at life?
Mm-hmm.
Y'all counted me out.
Yeah.
Y'all had me down bad out this bitch.
That's a fact.
And y'all tried to ice me. Mm-hmm. I got you niggas.
You niggas gonna pay.
Yes, nah, that's exactly the, you know, the vibe. That was the feeling. That was the thoughts right there. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's quiet for niggas now. You know what I'm saying?
Nah, he was popping his shit. Like, don't talk your shit. Yeah, because
I knew.
Popping his shit.
Like, me, like, I kind of got my confidence. I always have my confidence in my pen, but I just stopped giving a fuck about my situations and shit I couldn't control. Mm-hmm. And I just like, you know what I mean? Niggas can't fuck with me anyway. You know what I'm saying? Like, lyrically or streetwise or no way. You know what I'm saying? So it was like, fuck these niggas. And I just was on that type of time. And that's how I felt. All that shit, like, because niggas was counting me out. Niggas thought I wasn't going, you know what I'm saying? Niggas thought I wasn't going to overcome that obstacle. You know what I'm saying? So, you know what I mean?
And I'm
happy to prove niggas wrong.
And as sad as it is, it was just God teaching you a lesson.
Yeah, sure.
You feel what I'm saying? Somewhere in your course you wasn't going right, and he said, "No, I gotta make it right." Mm-hmm. And you might have been a street nigga to the point where it had to be something drastic, mm-hmm. because everything happened for a reason. Right. You feel what I'm saying?
Right.
And now that just make you even count your blessings even more. Like when I look at life, and I look at all the shit that I've been through, and I know that none of these niggas couldn't fuck with me with this rap shit. But now that I'm old, I wasn't ready. I would have got that money at a young age. Yeah. Shit. A lot of shit would have happened to a lot of niggas. Mm-hmm. I probably would have been you feel what I'm saying?
No, 100%.
So he didn't give it to me when I wanted it. Mm-hmm. It's when I realized that money wasn't everything. Is when I really start getting some money. Real shit. So, you know, and I'm glad that you embraced your flaws.
Yeah.
And made it work for you.
You got to.
Now it's just look like you on some gangster shit. I'm just keeping it real. You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah,
like,
yeah, yeah.
Like, for real. So, you know, I commend you, man, because you've been through a lot of shit, man. And in life, it ain't about what you go through. It's about how you bounce back. Your fucking bounce back game was notorious and glorious.
It was legendary.
King, nah, no question. So, you know what I mean? That's exactly my mind state. Like, you know what I mean? Sometimes we gotta turn our you know, what people might consider a disadvantage and use it as an advantage.
Absolutely. You
know, this episode of $1 Million Worth of Game is also brought to you by Roman Swipe.
Swim it!
I don't care where I'm at. I don't care where I'm going. Everywhere I go, I'm going somewhere. And guess what? People is always stealing my Romans.
Mm-hmm.
They come in the studio, steal the Romans. When we're on the road, they steal the Romans.
You know why?
Everybody steal the Roman swipes because you know what they do? When you wipe it on, whip it! You let it dry, you make her fly. I'm talking about clinically proven to help you last longer in the bed. Roman swipes. Who else is doing that? Nobody. Roman swipes. I'm talking about they. Listen, man. So many guys have come to me, hey, Wallo. Oh my God, you ain't gonna believe it. I was dancing in the end zone in the fourth quarter. I finally made it to the fourth quarter. If you didn't tell me about Roman swipes, I would have never made it to the fourth quarter.
Never.
Think about that. Think about what Roman swipes do. And guess what? For your first month of Roman swipes, just $5. $5 for your first month of Roman swipes. All you gotta do is go to getroman.com/game. That's it. Getroman.com/game and your first month of swipes is $5. What are you waiting for? RomanSwipes.com/game.
I was fortunate enough to like make my shit like a brand and like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
I'm damn near like a motherfucking action figure or something right now. I heard of these.
But fans, you was that like, cool. Think about that. Mm-hmm. Think about that. That niggas know me for one way. Yeah. I get shot. I get paralyzed. I'm a whole different way, but I'm so cool that y'all gonna love me this way too.
I'm still like
think
nigga.
About how powerful that shit
That's
is.
That's major.
Yeah, no question.
Think about that, bro. Because at the end of the day, you never probably even thought about it in that manner. Like, no, I'm really that nigga out here. Mm-hmm. Like most motherfuckers, 9 out of 10 motherfuckers that have happened to, even if they do embrace it, they fronting. They ain't truly embracing it. Yeah. It's just like, I gotta act like I don't give a fuck. But you had something in you that was like, nah, I really don't give a fuck. Fuck y'all niggas because I know I'm better than y'all niggas. Mm-hmm. When you got something in you and you really know you that nigga.
Can't stop it, man.
Can't
stop it. And the ladies loved him more after, I tell you that.
Right, because he owns some gangster shit. Yeah. Tell the bitch, shut up, get naked, bitch. All right, fuck this. He just looks so gangster when he say that. You feel what I'm saying? Right. And I'm going to tell you something, too. The fact that y'all made it at the ages that y'all made it at says the confidence that y'all niggas got.
Mm-hmm.
Says the belief that y'all niggas got that, no, we ain't giving up because we really know we them niggas. We going to crack through. That's a fact. A lot of niggas give up, man. A lot of niggas be them woulda, coulda, shoulda niggas, man. Mm-hmm. A lot of niggas be hitting 45. Man, if I'd have just.
Yeah.
Damn, I should have invested more. I should have spent more time in the studio, man.
Now, them niggas calling me right now. That's yeah. What they doing. Yo, Westside. Yo, man, listen, I want you to hear my motherfuckers. Like, come on.
You like, no, nigga, we're one in a million, a chance of a lifetime. He like, no, we signing all young niggas for me.
Yeah, that's it. Only young niggas. That's real, man.
Niggas had that shit. Listen, man, niggas be, that's what it is, niggas. That's niggas' biggest mistakes. Niggas just throwing the towel, man, too early on your wave, man. You know what I'm saying? You know, a lot of motherfucking billionaires and shit ain't really hit their stride till they was motherfucking late in the game.
Right.
You know, where we from consider late in the game. You know what I mean? Some people look at that shit like, I'm just getting started. You know what I'm saying?
Right. Right.
You know?
Shit, just a grown man's game, if you ask me. I always say that shit.
Like you said earlier, not to cut you out, like you said earlier, like, niggas that shit would have happened earlier when we was younger. We might not have been ready. You know
right.
What I'm saying?
Yeah.
Sometimes we was blessed to be able to get the journey out of this shit. You
right.
We didn't get the lesson.
Journey.
To learn. Struggle. Just,
if y'all had got that shit early, yeah. Benny wouldn't owe this fucking plug. He would have been the fucking plug.
Real shit.
He'd have been the plug. Yeah.
What I was saying is like, it's a grown man's game. They try to tell us it's a young man's game, but you got to think everybody who's a top contender in this rap shit or in anything. It's 30 plus. You know what I'm saying? You know, it's the young niggas, they up and coming and all that. But the top niggas in anything, that's basketball, that's football, that's rapping, that's skiing, you know what I'm saying? Cooking, whatever.
Golf,
boxing. You know what I'm saying? It's a nigga 30 plus. You know what I'm saying?
Mm. Well, he got a point there.
I never thought about that.
Because the top basketball player is either LeBron James, Kevin Durant, Steph Curry, Damian Lillard. All them niggas is...
Who the top rap niggas? Like, it's niggas who won't fight,
Drake.
But who the top... Right.
Yeah. J. Cole.
J. Cole 30?
Yeah, he gotta be at least 30.
Kendrick Lamar. 30. Kendrick ain't 30.
He close too.
Kendrick 30.
I believe he is. I don't know. Don't quote me on that, but I believe he is.
Yeah, so, I mean, you got a point. But, you know, the young niggas also... It's like... I look at the rapping shit like basketball. If you young and you hot and you just stay consistent and you keep putting in the work, your growth is going to be unbelievable.
Right.
So by the time you 28, 29, you done experienced so much shit. You done dealt with so many women.
Mm-hmm.
So you know the personalities. You done heard so much bullshit. I usually don't do this on the first night. The last 30 bitches said that. Get this dick. Stop playing. What the fuck is you talking about? Stop hitting me with that line. I used to go for that shit. My first tour, bitch. This is my fourth tour. I ain't going for that shit.
Yeah.
Stop playing. Do you want to get this dick or do you want to get out? Okay, go get this dick. So it's just like, it's a difference when you grown, mm-hmm. when you older. It's like you be less to play the games. You don't, it's like, you know, you this ain't your first rodeo. You mm-hmm. know what to expect. You already got your bitches in all the cities.
You know the meaning of life.
Down, bitch,
yeah, you know everything.
You know the meaning of life.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Oh, he had a relationship. You see how he skipped over the bitches and all
that. Yeah,
you know the meaning of life.
Like you said, just experiencing a lot of shit. You know what I mean?
Yeah, you just experienced a lot of shit.
You experienced a lot of shit.
That was funny.
Yeah.
You got your bitches in. You know the beat.
Yeah, man. The meaning of life is deep. That's some deep shit.
The meaning of life.
The meaning of life. Like, you understand.
Shut the fuck up, Kelly.
That's the beat. Yes, it is.
He talks to the bitches in every city.
He like, who? I don't know nothing about that.
Look at Benny. That was my ex-life. Was, baby, that was before I met you. I cut him off.
That's that old.
I threw that phone away.
That's how it should be.
For real.
Welcome to another edition of $1 Million Worth of Game Business Spotlight, where we bring to you people that's doing their thing. One thing about this brother right here, Van, he do what I do. Mm. I'm not, no. We don't do the same thing. We do things. He educate people on how to do it, and I'm out here doing it. Mm-hmm. Not saying he don't do it, but you know how that go. He do it too.
But let me say this.
Whatever.
You do educate our people about branding yourself. Your logos. I don't know how many shows we done talked to y'all.
I love that.
It's been specifically him about what's your logo? Do you got your LLC? How to get your LLC? What to make sure your logo is look a certain way. Now we got the king of that shit here.
But one thing about Van, he also teach you the importance of the story of a brand.
Mm-hmm.
A brand have to have a story in order for it to get legs up on it, for the engine to start, have to have a story. And guess what? I just got to throw it out there right now so you can understand. September 25th, I will be in Las Vegas with Van. Mm-hmm. And listen, we're not playing. You know what I mean? We're not playing. It's going down. So I'm going to be on stage with Van, and it's going down. So make sure y'all tap into what's going on. Tap into this number that he's going to give you, and tap into this game that he's going to get. Van, start, like, what is the first thing I do if I'm Johnny Nobody and I want to start a brand? I don't know nothing about it. I don't got I ain't got a bunch of followers on Instagram, but I want to start a brand and I want to become, or I want to become a brand. What do I do?
Well, the first thing you got to do is make sure you LLC your name. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
The first thing you got to do is make sure you, because you're going to get traction, because I'm about to tell you how to get traction. But the first thing you got to do is go take your name, LLC your name, because your name is your brand, right? So the next thing that you got to do is you got to see what you giving to the world, what you giving to the earth. You got to know exactly which value that you about to give, right? And then you got to get in tune with what your story is. What is your story that's going to make people resonate with you? And that's what I've been able to do to create my $1 million brand. Hustle the Entrepreneur. We in the building, man. Listen.
Right.
In 2018, my whole life got stripped from me. Police came to the door, knocked on the door, took everything I had. I'm black. I'm Muslim. They took everything. Thought I was a terrorist. Had guns. I like big guns with a lot of ammo, right? Mm. They thought I was a terrorist and took everything. I was fighting that case for 18 months, bro. So that's why I could resonate with your story.
Yes, sir.
I didn't do the time you did, but I did 18 months. So when I got out in 2018, I ended up beating the case. They was like, nah, we just playing. You ain't a terrorist, right? Let me out. I started with nothing, bro. I came out with absolutely nothing. But I had expertise in my head about what I wanted to do. And what I wanted to do was give value to the earth. I've been in the health and fitness space for 10 plus years. I got out and said, you know what? My story is I came from nothing. I want to help people. So I went to the gyms and said, you know what? Let me show you how to take your brand to the next level. So I went into the gym. I hired trainers. I told the gym, listen, you're in a community where people don't want to play basketball. People don't want to swim. These people want to get in and they want to just get in shape. Group training was popping at the time. So I came in and created a whole group training program for three gyms in my neighborhood in Arizona. Took them gyms from six figures to seven figures. Showed them how to be able to scale and now open up 10 new locations. So I said, okay, I got that. I got that. So from there, I said, you know what? Let me start helping other people outside of fitness. Because now I know how to be able to come in, show somebody how to be able to take what they got going and take it to the next level. So I would tell somebody that's starting right now, get in tune with what your story is. No matter if you lost everything, no matter where you at, and start giving value to your community first.
That's important. Now when you say you came out, you ain't had
nothing. And I don't want to cut him off.
I love the fucking, you know, I love this shit.
I don't want to cut him off, but it's funny that you say that because when Wallow came home from prison from doing 20 years, the first thing he did was run around to all the local businesses and gave them free promo.
I did the commercial because I had to get, like you said, I had to get my proof of concept of my brand and I had to get my value. So I would go to a store. Hey, how you doing, man? You got this Rib Shack. Can I do a commercial for you? They're like, commercial? What the f-? They didn't even have a clue. But I'm like, I got a little follow on Instagram. I'm gonna do it for free. I mean, whatever. They be like, all right, cool. I do it. Next thing you know, one of their friends calling me, can I get one of the commercials? Yeah, where you at? I'm talking about they wasn't paying me nothing. I wasn't getting no money, but I had to get my proof that when I do a commercial for you, it's value and it brings value. So I would go there. Yeah, hey, I'm Wallow 267. I'm at Johnny's Rib Shack. One thing about the ribs, when you bite into them, the meat gets stuck between your teeth. It's so tender. It fall off the bone. I'm talking about, listen, this sauce, I don't know how you make the sauce, but how do you make this sauce? Tell them what's got going on. Tell them how do you get down here. And it was popping. I got the Harrison line calling me. I got the clothing line calling me. I got the regular general store call. And it's just about that value that you've seen and bringing value to people. And that's how you was at. But if I want to get with you, and I'm talking about like, what is you teaching me? What is you teaching me? I'm just Johnny Nobody out here.
Johnny Nobody out here. Listen, stories sell, products and services don't. So we got to use that phone that we got. We got to use that Instagram, and we got to start telling our story on our page. We got to start showing people what you about and what value you give to the earth. So for example, start posting on social media right now, right away. If you're not posting on social media, you're doing it wrong. Nobody knows you. It's like back in the day when they used to say, if you don't got a website, you ain't got a business.
Yeah.
Right now, if you ain't got content on your page, you ain't got a business.
Damn. So that content is real powerful.
Content is everything.
Content running the earth right now.
So if I'm coming to your seminar and I'm coming and I'm Johnny Nobody, what is I'm learning? What is the steps that I'm learning to be able to take my brand to the next level?
14 questions you got to know. What's the problem of the people that you want to help? What's the frustration of the people that you want to help? What are they complaining about to their friends and family on a day-to-day basis in relation to the problem that you solve? It's 2 a.m. Your client is looking up at the ceiling, that ceiling fan that we all got in our house that make noise. What is they fearful of, anxious of? What do they want to accomplish? What's the most pressing crisis in their life right now that they need solved right away? You need to be able to answer those questions about your products and services, what you be able to help this person with. Mm-hmm. And then from there, you got to start producing content that has to do with showing them that you are the authority in that space to be able to solve those problems. And then when you attract that person to your page, they're going to be like, oh, damn, he know what I'm dealing with. Man, he know my problems. He know what I'm complaining about. And he's been able to overcome it. So they look at you as the authority in their space and they start rocking with you.
So that's how you've been able since 2018 to be able to become a millionaire off of, teaching people about branding because they look at you as the authority of your space.
Look at me as the authority in my space and I'm telling my story every single day and I'm showing them about my life and what I do. And I'm using the hustler to entrepreneur movement as the vessel to get them to that thing. Cause we all been hustling, right? That's the reason why I call it hustler to entrepreneur. We've been hustling day to day. Every day we hustle trying to get the rent paid, trying to get the bills paid, but we have no vision forward, right? So entrepreneurship is about having systems in place, having people in place, having a team in place, having a vision that has legs on it more than our day-to-day hustle. So that's why I created the brand Hustler to Entrepreneur to help hustlers start becoming entrepreneurs using a story, they trip ups in life and turning them into triumph.
You're teaching hustlers to legitimize their hustle.
Exactly.
And put the infrastructure around this hustle because he's saying, listen, y'all know how to grind. You know how to get to some money. But is it like that lack of infrastructure don't give you the support you need? Like, even last year, a lot of people, they had hustles. They didn't have businesses, so they couldn't benefit from the money that the government was giving because there was no infrastructure there. Now, say I'm just some examples. Say I'm the guy, I know how to make a mean turkey burger.
Mm-hmm.
I know how to make a mean turkey burger, but I'm making it out the crib. How would you help me?
Yeah, so I actually got a story, man. I helped a guy that wanted to open a restaurant, man. He was a beast at the food, right? He had a big social media following, right? He was dropping content every day, but he wanted to get a restaurant.
And how was he making his food? Just in the crib?
Man, he was making his food out the crib. He was hustling, making his food out the crib. Everybody in the neighborhood knew about him, and the people on Instagram would come to the house. He would have like meal preps and stuff like that, but he wanted to get into a restaurant. So I said, you know what? Instead of getting into a restaurant, we're going to go to the 5 restaurants in the neighborhoods that got slow days, right? So we went, 3 turned them down. The 4th one said maybe, but the 5th one said, yep, let's do it, right? So then every Tuesday we had that day from 4 o'clock to 8 o'clock, he started posting on his Instagram where he was going to be. And then people showed up and it started selling out. His page got bigger. His following got bigger. The restaurant was making more money. So them other 4 restaurants that turned him down, they like, oh, well, you can get Wednesday. The other restaurant was like, all right, you can get Friday.
So he would move to a different restaurant every week.
Every single day of the week. It started with 1 for the first month. He was killing it. Started with two, then three, then four, then five. Now my man traveling around the country doing pop-up restaurants.
And all he needs is a dead day. He don't have to have no...
Nope.
He don't have to have no... They got the, they provide the infrastructure. They provide the equipment. Everything is already there. He come in there, bring his food, and go right in.
Because his brand was his food. His brand was the fact that he wasn't stationary. His brand was the fact that he came from nothing, kicking from the house, but he given such a good value and the food tastes so good, but people from the hood resonate with him. Right. Uh-huh. They resonated with his story. He grew his following. He grew his tribe, basically. Right. That's another thing. You got to grow a tribe. Uh-huh. You have a tribe. You have people that wait every single morning for you to post. Uh-huh. But you've been able to do that by consistency. My man was consistent. He was consistently posting. He was consistently showing people where he was going to be. He was consistently making
cooking,
people.
Number one.
Yes. Cooking. Yes. Right. But it was a hustle. And now it's a business. Now he got a multi-million-dollar business. Right. It's the same thing with me. I was hustling. I used to hustle in the gyms. I used to train people for $20 an hour, $30 an hour, hustling from gym to gym. And I said, you know what? I got the blueprint for the gyms. They're in neighborhoods and they're giving services to people that don't necessarily want the amenities in their gym. So let's find out what the people really want. So what we did is we just surveyed the community. Hey, what do y'all really want from this particular gym? And I said, listen, this is what the people in your neighborhood saying that they want. And then they took off. I took that and took it back to the hood. Because at the end of the day, I can only resonate with people that honestly look like me and is where I'm from. And yes. I'm a hustler. You know what I'm saying? But now we done turned it into entrepreneurship. That's how we're able to touch seven figures. That's how we're being able to help other people touch seven figures, because you have to get out the hustle mentality of the day to day. And you got to be consistent with what you want to do. And it starts with the content. Man, I love Instagram. I love Facebook. I love social media, because now you can get in front of millions of people every single day.
What is your best platform for branding?
Instagram.
And why is that?
Because everybody is on their phone every single day for entertainment purposes. Some come for education. Some see where they need to level up. So if you have a message and you have a story and you're consistent, people are going to adapt to that. Like, for example, you got a nanosecond. You got 2 seconds to really capture people into your content. So what I show people is how to hit them in the mouth in the first 2 to 3 seconds. Yeah, I used to mess up and say, hey, it's Van Taylor here, Mr. Go All In. I already lost them. That's 3 seconds already. Right. I need to hit them in the mouth right now.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
You need to choke ground by the neck, grab, get all that attention, because it's a battle for attention on social media.
Mm-hmm. So for anybody out there that's looking to put some type of infrastructure or, you know, learn about how your brand can become huge and bigger on a day-to-day basis, how do they get in contact with you?
Oh, man, all they got to do is text me, $1 million worth of game.
MWG.
Text MWG.
Yep, to 949-508-1160. That's all they got to do.
Oh, we got to run that back again. We talking about, we need you to text MWG to where?
949-508-1160.
MWG, text that to where?
949-508-1160. 1160.
Listen, man, it's going down, and that's what it's about. But it's like this dude that had this restaurant, that idea is like, I know a lot of people going to take that idea and run because there's so many restaurants. It's oversaturated with restaurants, but all these restaurants ain't jumping.
Nope.
So if you out there, you better take this game. That was $1 million worth of game for free that he had.
Give us another instance of somebody you helped take to the next level.
Yeah. So I got a brother, man, that, he came from the trap, right? He came from the trap, but he came to trap of the 9-to-5. The 9-to-5 trap of working for minimum wage, working for a little bit over minimum wage. But my man was an expert in the credit repair game. Mm-hmm. He was helping people outside of his job get their credit right and take it to the next level. So he had a big following. He actually was working with a company that was a MLM company, to where he was feeding them the sales, right? MLM companies is cool. But I said, you know what, bro? You need to build your own brand. So what happened was he got fired from his job. They actually fired him because he found out that they was helping him in credit repair. So what we did was we got real consistent on social media about telling people about how he got fired from his job, right? But he was able to take an 800 credit score and be able to leverage his business to be able to grow and scale his business. So he started attracting people that wanted to fire their boss and people that did get fired. And we helped him grow to 6 figures a month. He just hit his first 100K month last month, right? By being able to tell his story and show people, listen, I got fired from my job because I was helping people. And no matter where you at in your business, no matter where you at, you can take your brand to the next level by just getting your credit right. Start investing in your business, right? Because credit is a big key, right? Credit rules the world. So he showed people how, listen, you can leverage this credit. You can take your 500 credit score, you can get it fixed, and you can take it to the next level. And he just kept hitting the content hard and hard and hard, and he's grown a big following, and now he's doing 100K months, right? From literally being fired from his job less than a year ago.
That's major.
That's big.
One thing I'm going to say is this. If you out there, you're trying to build the brand. Once again, I need you to text. I'm talking about right now. Mm-hmm. Text. Put this shit on pause. Text MWG to where, man?
949-508-1160.
I'm talking about MWG to where?
949-508-1160.
I'm talking about hustler to entrepreneur. This is what's going on. Van came here, he's gave y'all game for free. What the fuck you going to do now? Is you going to get, like, what you going to do? Like, what else you going to do? What's your Instagram, Van?
Yep, my Instagram is at thevantaylor1, T-H-E-V-A-N-T-A-Y-L-O-R-1. It's only one account. Don't be out there looking at them other accounts. TheVanTaylor1, that's the only one I got. And listen, when they text me, I'm actually going to give them a free blueprint on how to grow their brand in 90 days to six figures. If they follow these steps that I'm going to give them when they text me, I'm going to actually give them a free blueprint of how to build their brand to six figures and beyond in the next 90 days. If they text me, they're going to get a gym.
They getting that for free.
They getting that for free.
So you mean to tell me you ain't like you getting
nah,
that?
Nah, nah. I'm giving them a whole video series of how to grow their brand literally from nothing. I don't care where you at, whether you making money in your brand, whether you ain't making no money, whether you making $10,000 a month, $20,000 a month. It's gonna be a blueprint in there to take it to the next level. If they text me, they're gonna get the blueprint.
Well, you already know what's going on. Once again, I'm gonna tell you this right now. What I need you to do is text MWG to where?
949-508-1160.
Listen, man.
Don't say we ain't look out.
Don't say we ain't look out. I appreciate
That's
you, man.
That's what we do.
Listen, if you want to be, I'm telling you, you want to go from hustler to entrepreneur, text that number right now. Stop playing. Another $1 million worth of game. Business spotlight.
Are y'all in relationships, though?
I am.
You are? Yeah. How long you been in a relationship?
I've been in a relationship for 7 years.
Oh, yeah. He definitely.
I used to live in the projects
city.
With
He's
her.
Playing.
Babe. Oh. You used to live in the projects.
I used to live in the projects with her.
Oh, this is gangster.
You know what I'm saying?
Oh, he's scared to death of her.
He's scared.
He's scared to death of us. She he ain't got to worry about. She icy mouth.
She ain't going nowhere.
She
a finishing.
What?
No. She gangsters, but she be on her shit. You know what I'm saying? She from the projects, but she distinguished.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? To a point like me, I'm ratchet as a motherfucker. But you know what I mean? She was in the trenches with me. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, but you better not play no games with the boss.
Play no games.
We know who the fuck the boss is.
That's real.
See, she going to tell you. Just clean that shit up. But
you can't be this old and get this lit and fuck with these new bitches. It's impossible.
Why?
Because they don't know who you are. See, a bitch got to really know me, who I am. You know what I'm saying? To deal with me.
Right.
And to be honest with you, you know, Benny the Butcher, you know, he a rap nigga, but that ain't all the way me. You know what I'm saying? This lifestyle and all of that ain't all the way me. So a bitch get around and get to fall in love with that. Like, no, but you got to know the roots.
Right.
I got to take you to Buffalo and give you that Underground Railroad tour.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And understand where this comes from.
You know? Yeah, no, for real.
That's a fact.
These are the new pieces ain't going to be able to understand this shit.
He took his woman on a chitlin' circuit.
Yeah, come on, we got to go down here.
See this.
That's real.
How long you been with yours?
14 years.
14 years, huh?
Where you meet at?
Shit, prison.
He did one of my jobs, but he succeeded on a prison visit.
Wait, hold on. Was you on BeTheFuckingPrisoner.com?
No, he wasn't.
Nah. So
He was on BeTheFuckingPrisoner.com. That's why I meant it. He had a profile.
Nah, come on, man. He's blowing. Yeah. Chill. Yeah. Fucking his high up.
Now, you know, my aunt was visiting me, and she used to visit her uncle. Her uncle, you know what I'm saying, he was getting a bag from Kingston because she's Jamaican, you know what I'm saying? And so you know how it is. Like, she was visiting me. I mean, you know, my aunt was visiting me, and so they table was right next to us. So when it was time for a bathroom visit, my aunt had to go to the bathroom. Her uncle had to go to the bathroom. So I'm just sitting there chilling. She's sitting there. I'm saying, I used to see her come to the visits all the time, but of course, she was across the room, you know what I mean? So this particular time, she was right next to me. So shit, we just started kicking and talking or whatever. So then when they came back from the bathroom, you know, we was just all communicating. So my aunt and her was like, yo, how about when, you know, it's time for a visit, we just come up here together, that way we can always just try to sit next to each other. And shit, they started doing that. We started sitting next to each other, and I put her on my phone list. You know what I mean? Because the joint I had at that time, she was falling off. So I'm like, damn, let me just start hitting shorty. So I start calling her, and then shit, when I got out, She was right there, took me to the halfway house.
Been on ever since.
How long was you locked up before you came home?
Three years?
3 years.
So
she rode 3 years with you?
Yeah, well, like a year. We was together for like a year.
Oh, so you came home in about a year after you met her?
Yeah, and then like...
You would keep it all
with your relationship. That's what I told her. I'm like, yo, don't think I'm one of these niggas in here that ain't coming home in 20 and 30. Like, I'll be out next year. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So, because you know how I was at first, like... Like I said, I'm in my tans, but you know I'm smelling good.
You got your whole thing.
I got that good G-Shock.
Did you pull your shit from under the mattress?
Nah.
So hold on. So you had the PR, you had the prison recipe going, huh?
Yeah. I'm smelling good. Tim's crispy. You know come what I mean? Out. My creases. I was doing my 1-2. Yeah, my G-Shock waves were spinning. Yeah. I'm about 40 pounds lighter than this.
Oh, here you go. Let me just tell you what happened. He was down to a year, so he started working out. I'm killing bitches when I get home. That's what all niggas do. They sit up there, they hold bed, then they get to a year. They doing 1-hour push-ups and shit. Come home looking like an action figure. That shit lasts all the 4 months. They got to eat cheese sticks and shit. Hey, so let me ask you a question. You was up there. You was, the game that you was spitting across that motherfucking table had to be immaculate.
It was. You know what I'm saying? For real. Like, she was looking good as a motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? Like, I always say, like, I always tell niggas all the time, like, look at these rap niggas, baby mamas before the deal. Mm. You know what I'm saying? They can't even get close to mine. You know what I'm saying?
So, before the deal. Wow.
Yeah, look at they baby moms before the deal. You know what I'm saying? That let you know what type of niggas they was too.
Baby mom like this.
For real. You know what I'm saying? So nah, but she held it down. She
who that? That was my first baby mom. Damn. You know? Where's she from? What part of the village she from? Monkey Mountain. Monkey Mountain.
Straight gangster though, Jamaican.
Held it down for you.
Word up. Still right now to this day. She flying out here in the morning.
But the baby, you know what's so crazy? You said that upstairs and you was happy when you said it.
He was like,
my wife was mean. Pootie coming. She be in the morning. Pootie coming, man. Damn, I thought Pootie was going to be in early. Man. You was happy when you was saying that shit, man.
Nah, family is everything.
This episode of $1 Million Worth of Game is also brought to you by Simply Safe. One thing I like about Simply Safe, secure your family, the people that you love so most. We always talking about, I love my family. You love the dog. If you love the dog, protect the dog. And it's simple to protect the dog. That's why it's Simply Safe. What are you waiting for? What you need to do right now is get with Simply Safe, because Simply Safe, you know, they got some new stuff going on. Wireless outdoor security camera. Mm. All you got to do is visit simplysafe.com/game. When you know what's more, Simply Safe is celebrating a new camera by offering 20% off. Mm. You get 20% off. And your new, I'm talking about 20% off your entire new system and your first month of monitoring service free when you enroll in an interactive monitoring service. What are you waiting for? Simply Safe. They're not playing no games. Why are you playing games? They want to help you protect your family. Why are you not trying to be so eager to protect your family like Simply Safe is providing the service to protect your family? What you need to do, once again, go to simplysafe.com/game. And guess what? They're going to hook you up. Stop playing games. Simply Safe.
Let me ask y'all a question, man. How do y'all, because I know all y'all days ain't sunny. You know, as you grow, as you, you know, you're winning, as even before you're winning, y'all got a sense of I'm that nigga. So I know some days y'all see shit in a different way, you know, because a part of being great is not always agreeing. Mm-hmm. That's just a part of being great, because in order for us to be great, it has to be a rebuttal. It has to be, hold on, what's the pros and what's the cons of this shit? You feel what I'm saying? So when y'all go through y'all little debates, or you know, how do y'all manage to get over it and still be solid and still be one? You feel what I'm saying?
Right.
I mean, my thing is always, it's my family. You know what I'm saying? Like, no matter what, you know what I'm saying? That's that's always just going to be the common denominator. That's always going to be, no matter what, at the end of the day, like, I ain't about to say they governments, but, like, this is this person, this is that person. Like, right. You know what I'm saying? Like,
so you call a nigga up, damn, Al, man, step back up. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But for real, like, that's just always, you know what I'm saying? Just, that's how I look at it, just no matter what, you know what I'm saying? Period. Like, you know, everybody else, I'm a nigga who quick to cut a nigga off fast, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But, like, at the end of the day, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's family, you know what I'm saying? I really love niggas, you know what I'm saying? So,
you know, niggas was in the trenches together. We see this happen all the time. You know, niggas be poor together and get this money, and the money destroy the relationship.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? That's the craziest shit in the world to me.
Yeah, that is crazy to me, too. I don't understand.
How we reach our dream. This is what we are dreaming about, and it's fuck the relationship. Which, you know, this business is tricky, but just like you said, it's always family. And it's always about, you know what I'm saying, like, this shit bigger than everybody sitting right here. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
You just got to understand that and understand the part you play in it and the role you play in it and respect the role that everybody else play in it. You know what I'm saying? Longevity type shit.
Right. And one thing I want to say to all the youngins that's out there, man, that come up with your team, and if everybody play a role, man, when y'all get the money and y'all had the disagreements, and unless your man on some straight bullshit, because sometimes your people could be on some bullshit that can jeopardize shit, and you gotta let a nigga go. But if it's on some disagreement shit, on some regular shit, and we just don't see eye to eye, and ain't no money ever gonna make me and Wallow not fuck with each other.
No, never.
You know what I'm saying? That's just the reality of this shit, because we fuck with each other when we didn't have no money. Mm-hmm. Now, we got money. We fuck with each other as kids.
That's my family.
Now we got money and we don't see eye to eye. We gonna stop fucking with each other? That just to me, that's not no real shit. Because at the end of the day, I'll be the one to call and tap out. Listen, cuz, man, listen, we on some bullshit, man. You feel what I'm saying?
First.
I'm gonna beat you fuck up when I catch you, man. You ain't gonna call me in 2 weeks, pussy. I'm gonna tension.
I'm gonna duck you like Benny ducked the plug when he burned him. He ran away with the plug money.
He was the ducker, bitch.
Yeah, that nigga was doing some duck shit.
Come on. And when I finally seen him, finally ran into him, I seen him. Like, I called him over to me like I was looking for him.
Where you been?
So you gotta turn this shit on.
Hey, that's how you turn it around. That's how you turn around.
Damn,
you
see man, a nigga looking for you, man.
You see a nigga, you open. Come here, man. Confuse the shit out of him. What the fuck? Fuck you been at, nigga?
You know you gotta play the game. You know what I mean?
Fuck's wrong? I hit that line. Your line ain't the same, nigga. Cause I'm gonna hit you.
You know, get him. No.
That shit real, man.
But listen, man.
Hold up, Armani, Liz. Why you the shit?
I mean, so many reasons. I feel like, you know, ain't no other female out there that like sound like me, that look like me. Mm. Simultaneously.
Mm-hmm. She talk heavy.
That, you know, like, cause I came up around some hitters. So it's like, one thing about it, they not gonna take it easy on me. And like, you know, y'all already know they get busy. Like, I really get busy. That's why I be feeling like it's so like, it's such like a slap in the face when like I drop like the Liz, or, you know, I do something like the Liz too, and niggas be feeling like, oh, yeah, well, Conway must have been writing for her. Westside wrote that. Man. Like, you know, because I really push my pen. Mm-hmm. And they don't, you know, like, they don't let up on me at all. Like, I'll play some shit for a nigga, and if it ain't hitting, they'd be like, nah, that shit is horrible. Mm-hmm. Or, nah, you need to go harder. Like, but, again, like, I wasn't no overnight success. I had a chance to actually sharpen my pen, actually, you know, really get into it, study music, you know what I'm saying? Like, I took a hip-hop and context class in college, so, like, it gets deep. These bitches ain't degree. Fucking with me. Huh?
You got your degree.
Oh, nah. I left after my advisor told me I could sell ice to an Eskimo. I was a marketing major.
Oh, shit.
And once they told me that, it was like, it's dumb. But
you be on the gram.
Yeah.
Killing them. You be trapping.
I mean, you know, like,
you be killing them.
I'm going to say this, and I know a lot of girls going to probably get, you know, because I'm kind of like spilling the tea, but you know, it's really about the packaging. Because if you really get to know me, or if you really pay attention enough, you know that it's way more than, you know, the exterior. It's really like, you know, I get busy on the mic. I'm a hell of a businesswoman. Like, I got multiple businesses. You know what I'm saying? I'm getting into my real estate bag now. And I'm able to capitalize off this shit to where if I really want to wash my hands with music, I don't got to do music no more. But if I want to wash my hands with, you know, like, I'm doing it because it's fun to me.
Bad bitch.
Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So, like, if it really came down to it, and I really, like, you know, because I'm serious about the shit now. But if I'm really, like, want to get in my bag, it'll be over for bitches, you know. But I respect everybody because I ain't like going to be one of them type that.
I like how she clean that shit.
Like, when I sum it up, basically what she's saying, bitches, is this winter she throwing ones in the fireplace to keep the house warm.
Oh, no, it's over. Like, all winter. You know, and I do this shit for fun. Like, that, but that just goes to show, like, I love my craft. I really, you know, again, I'm seasoned, like, and I'm not new to this shit. And I don't have to do this to make no bag. You know what I'm saying? That's just the icing
on the cake.
So
you do
it
because you love it.
I do it because I love it, and I would do it for free.
You got me so hype. I'm ready to ask her for a 16.
No, but for real, like, you, that's what it comes down to. A lot of people in this game don't do it for the love of it no more. They do it because it's a check behind it. They do it because they want a platform or whatever. I do it because I really love music. I really love music. I really grew up a hip hop head, and I really, that's why I respect all of these niggas, because when we was in the studio, when we was in Shea studio, and just, you know what I'm saying, broke, doing bad, down bad, we was making fire music. And I knew they was fire, and I was fire too. Like, you know, like, sometimes I may call them up, like, yo, like, can you believe this shit? Like, you see me be doing this shit, like, yo, like, because I really, I can't believe it some days, because, but on the other hand, it's like, I seen it. I'm like, these niggas is way too nice to not be on. You know what I'm saying? Like, Wes was the first art connoisseur I ever knew. We from Buffalo. It wasn't no motherfucking, who was talking about art? Yeah. Like, oh, you know what I'm saying? I wasn't a thing.
About it now.
Yeah.
They know Buffalo now.
Yeah, like,
they know Buffalo other than losing them 4 fucking Super Bowls. Because y'all had it down bad for a long fucking time till y'all came and saved the day. You niggas came like superheroes. Da, da, da. Get that shit out your mind. As soon as you thought about Buffalo, the niggas that won, lost 4 back-to-back Super Bowls. Oh, yeah, we know about them niggas.
Get that shit out your mind.
Yeah, y'all got that shit out of niggas' minds fast. Now, you mentioned Buffalo now. Yeah, Griselda. Yeah.
Talking big shit.
You know what I'm saying? They getting keys to the city and all that type of shit. They got total support from the city. You don't see that a lot. Like,
know.
They love y'all up there, man. The city, you just see, like, they love y'all up there, man. You know, but I just want to give y'all brothers y'all flowers. Dope, y'all doing man. Y'all thing. Every time I see y'all, I salute y'all in traffic, wherever right. it's at. Yeah. I'm on the phone with y'all, just like, y'all really doing it, and y'all showing people that everything is possible, not any everything. 100%. You know what I mean? And like, because I ain't going front. Everybody on this, except on mine, we are older niggas, and we getting money. We making it the fuck happen. Yeah. So if you out there.
Don't tell my motherfucking business like that.
Yeah, I ain't saying that.
I'm busted and disgusted. I'm, you know, the fuck is you trying to do?
I'm capping.
I'm already Instagram, taking fucking, you know, care of 10 family members. Right. Fuck you trying to take it to 15.
Yeah, well, whatever the case may be. We're still successful.
I'm busted. He's getting them niggas getting money.
Listen, we still call that nigga if you need a loan, cuz. We all successful here, and we over the age of success. As the system say, oh, you got to be 18 to what, 22? If you're not that, this is a young man's sport.
Yeah.
I can't tell.
We don't believe in
that. I can't tell. Everybody right here got activated in their
30s. That's a narrative. They
and they shit heavy. Man. I ain't going to lie. These niggas over here.
Oh, y'all change is crazy. Y'all getting, yeah, this shit is a blizzard.
Shit heavy.
It's cold as shit down here.
Niggas gotta hustle.
I need a jacket.
Like this nigga, you think he got enough light?
God damn.
This nigga got 11 chains on. He got pieces, hiding pieces and shit. Oh, I forgot I had this one.
That shit, yeah. But I just want to give y'all flowers, man. Y'all niggas the shit. Keep doing y'all.
Thank you.
Y'all represent y'all city that never was represented in the way y'all. So always be mindful of that. Yeah. And I can imagine the minds y'all woke up, them young minds in Buffalo. Mm-hmm. I can't wait to hear them young. There's some young cats down there that's looking at y'all that now can see it, because a lot of times y'all didn't have nothing to see. Y'all had to look at. Now when you got somebody in the city and y'all coming through and red race and all this crazy shit and red G-Wag, they like, oh, we could do this shit. Going back down the neighborhood, standing at the old crib, and I mean, like, anything is possible. So salute y'all 100%. For putting y'all city on the map and inspiring the young cats from y'all city, because if you live in the city, wherever you out there, you're successful, you giving the young cats something to look at to and something to aspire to be and say, they come from the same ghetto as me. I could do it if they could do it. And that's what it's about.
Right.
Salute
right.
y'all, man.
Yes, sir, man. You already know. Thank you, man. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's what we doing. And just look out, you know what I'm saying, for drum work. Look out for BSF. Look out for more Griselda. Like, we, you know, we can't bring everybody on at the same time. Mm-hmm. But if you look at our rosters and what we doing, we already putting the younger homies on right now, you know what I'm saying, to keep the tradition going. You know, keep this Buffalo shit going. And you know what I'm saying? You already know. We Buffalo here, man. But it's a Buffalo nigga that had the longest billboard in Times Square ever.
Yes,
not a New York nigga. Let me say that.
Yes. Right.
And let me just say this. The future. There's a lot of more Buffalo kid chains coming.
BSF chains coming. Drumwork chains is coming.
Do you deserve a Buffalo kid chain? Are you talented enough?
Yes.
If you are, it's a chain waiting on you. And it's just like that.
Right!